1950, the Indian judiciary is facing a problem of delays, the overloaded dockets. And we had reports after reports for bringing about various judicial reforms. And despite having expert bodies constituted, reports generated, the problem was not being overcome.
The information regarding various status of the cases was taking a long time to reach the citizens, especially the litigants. We felt ICT is one of the best technologies which will facilitate in disseminating this information faster.
The litigants were facing a lot of problems in grant of certified copies. It used to take 2 months, 5 months, 6 months. Even we had the instances for 4 years the copies were not granted.
We initiated work in the Supreme Court to provide a system by which the cause list, that means that all the listing of the cases is concerned, and the judgments which are being issued by the Honorable Court are put on a web base so that they can be available in a faster pace to the litigants in this country.
We evolved the method of automation. And now the position is that within half an hour, certified copies are being granted. And with a nominal cost of 5 rupees, 10 rupees. Whereas earlier it used to take 2,000, 5,000, anything amount which could be charged.
On the advice of the Chief Justice of India, E-Committee was set up to set up a vision for the next 10 years' time. What should be the ICT usage in the court? And secondly, work out a national plan, a strategy plan for the for ICT in the judiciary.
We have also devised an action plan. Now it is in 3 phases. The first phase comprises of 2 years, the second phase again comprises of 2 years, and the third phase is 1 year. In first 2 years, we want to make the Supreme Court and the High Court completely ICT enabled in all respects. Parallelly, we start introducing ICT in the district and subordinate courts across the country to bring all the courts at the same level. Simultaneously, we will start doing the video conferencing facilities, connecting all the jails and prisons with the courts. This we intend to complete within the next 3 years. The total expenditure what we have planned for complete ICT enablement of the judiciary should be near about 850 crores. As a part of a national policy, we have decided that we will give laptops to each of the judges, and simultaneously we start giving them the ICT expertise training. The process has started at Delhi, with 100 judges of the Delhi district judiciary taking this training here as a pilot project.
A special program has been designed for judicial officers in computer training, and 100 judicial officers, they are receiving intensive computer training in the judicial academy for the last about more than 2 months.
It has improved our functioning. You can say earlier the steno used to take sufficient time in typing judgments and correcting them, again retyping or making up, supplying the copies to the supposed convicts. Now we have been provided LCD. On seeing the LCD, we come to know what are the mistakes being committed by these stenos. We immediately then and there ask him to correct it. Now there is, you can say, neatness, cleanness in the judgments.
Previously announced judgments as well as my orders, they are all on the internet. So earlier they were all compiled in the files which have been consigned to record room. It was very difficult to get those files from there and then see what I had earlier pronounced in a particular case. Now they are available on the internet, so it can be easily seen, accessed from there.
And not only this, they come in the afternoon for training. In the forenoon they are having the practical experience of what they are learning here to utilize it in the courts. And they say that every day when they go to the courts, they go as a better officer.
Suppose you have to take a back reference, you can just tell your steno, take that judgment, copy it. So you can get the judgment ready in a short time.
All the judgments of Supreme Court are published on the internet the very next day. You have not to run about here, there, or you are not required to spend anything. So the filing is concerned, earlier used to take 15 days, 1 month, 2 months in getting the numbers, registration number of the case. Now it is an hour's affair. You file it, if it defective, you get the number instantaneously, the computer generates it.
I can get an access to whatever orders have been passed, whatever is the status of my applications, whatever is the status of my petitions, my cases, whatever it is, I can just by a click of mouse, I can get everything.
It gives a great satisfaction for us students, because when the lawyers and litigants tell us, I didn't have to go to the Supreme Court or the High Court to know what is the status of his case. Sitting down in some nook corner of the country, he is able to find out the status of case and also the related materials in that particular area.
With the use of ICT, the litigants or the justice seekers in the country will very soon start getting the justice, which will be speedy, which will be quality justice, which will be cost effective, and in a transparent manner. This has not happened in the past. For his ineptness and the failure of human agencies. But the use of technology will certainly answer to the litigants' needs and the perceptions.